Guys, Happy New Year, it's 2021, but you know what January means, right? Yep, budgeting season. Now, don't worry, before you clock off this video, I'm actually going to be walking through how you can actually budget your money using the zero-based budgeting method. Because of course, guys, Auntie V's always got your back. Hello, welcome and welcome back to my channel. My name is Veronia and I talk about things to do with money, your career and having a positive mindset for success. So if you do like the sound of that, then you can subscribe to my channel and hit the bell notification below so you don't miss out on any new videos. So what I thought would be fun to do today is, rather than looking at my own budget, because sometimes it can be a bit different, particularly because my expenses are very low, I thought I would actually make a persona and we are gonna have a case study. And I'm just gonna use this video to walk through and show you guys how I would actually budget this person's money. So guys, meet Ronnie. Hi everyone, so nice to meet you. My name is Ronnie and I am 27 years old. I currently live and work in London. So I earn about £38,000 a year from my job. And I also rent a one bedroom flat for myself, which is just outside London. So my rent is about £1,300 a month. I know, quite expensive, but it is London. Now I do have credit card debt and I have debt from my store cards, plus my car is financed too. But I also do have a mini emergency fund just in case anything happens as well. But what I really need to do is just make a budget because I have no idea where my money goes. So as mentioned before, I am actually going to be using the zero-based budget method. And if you don't know what that means, you are basically going to be allocating all of your pennies, your pounds, everything to a job. So it all has a category that it needs to be aligned to. And I have actually done a previous video talking about the zero-based budgeting method in a bit more detail. So if you haven't watched that, of course, I'll put that up here for you and in the description below. So what we're going to be doing is we are going to use my own budgeting spreadsheet and we are going to be walking through the person's net worth currently, and we're also going to be looking at how I would budget their own money as well for the month of January as an example. And this spreadsheet is actually being launched today as well, because New Year's Day and January. So if you do want to purchase that from me, I will put the link in the description below. You can purchase it from my Etsy store. Anyway, enough talking, let's get to it. And first we are going to look at Ronnie's actual net worth. Now if you don't know what a net worth is, it basically is your assets minus your liabilities. So in terms of assets, it might be things that you actually own or that actually puts money in your pocket. So for example, that could be savings or investments, or if you've got a pension, for example. Whereas with liabilities, I like to think of that as basically taking money out of your pocket or where you actually owe something. So for example, your credit card debt, any store credit card debt, any personal loans, car loans, all of that stuff. So I've actually populated Ronnie's net worth already. So she's currently in £2,000 credit card debt. She's also got a £500 store credit card debt as well. And also she's actually taken a loan for her car as well for about £15,000. So in terms of the total, we can see total liabilities is about minus £17,500. Now in terms of assets, she doesn't really have many assets, unfortunately, but that's okay. That's something that she can start working towards. So no fret. At the moment, she has about £1,000 in her emergency fund, and she's decided that that £1,000 is going to be a starter emergency fund because she really wants to start paying off her debt. But she decided to have £1,000 just in case anything happened to her, like her car broke down. So all in all, that means that her total net worth is about minus £16,500. So if you do decide to get my spreadsheet, what I've done is I've actually got a summary underneath here, and this is basically going to show her total liabilities versus her total assets. So you can see in Ronnie's case, her total liabilities is all the way down in the minus, and she's only got a little bit of assets as well. So hopefully during each month, those liabilities will start to decrease, and then it may get to a point where her assets actually start to increase as well. So hopefully that blue line will start to go up. And then she's gonna move on to her sinking funds. So in this tab, this is a calculator in terms of whether you want to do sinking funds or maybe some debt overpayment. So sinking funds is really things that you can start to save up for, and you can divide it by the number of months, and then that will give you a savings goal each month. So for example, if you wanted to save up for Christmas and you decided you want to save up, say, £300 for your Christmas presents by the end of the year, you could then divide that by how many months you want to save. So for example, you might want to save for 11 or 12 months, and then that number will be your savings for each month. What Ronnie has basically decided is that she really wants to start paying off her debt this year. So she's got a range of sinking funds and debt overpayments that she needs to put away for this year. So what she's decided based on her goals is that she's going to try and pay off her store credit card this year, plus she's going to try and start attacking that other credit card as well. So in this scenario, what we're going to say is we are actually going to say her total is her store credit card, it's £500. And what she's going to try and do is she's going to start overpaying from now. So what we're going to do is we're going to start from December 20, because in this scenario, which is very similar to mine, I get paid at the end of December and that's for my January paycheck. But what the calculator will do is it actually calculates whole months. So rather than me starting from January, I need to say that it's from December, and that's going to go to, I've decided she is going to try and pay it off by April. So that's going to give her 4 months, and that means she needs to be setting aside £125 to go towards overpaying for that debt. And remember, at the same time, she's also going to be making her other minimum payments to whatever other debts she has. Once she's then paid that off in April, which is happy days, she's then going to move over to her credit card. So she's going to try and start attacking that credit card. So with her store credit card, she actually had a minimum payment of £5. So what she's going to do is that £5 is going to go towards her other debt payoff. So when she's trying to pay off that credit card, so rather than having £125, she now has £130 that she can try and put towards that debt. So hopefully that will have paid off about £1,040 by the end of this year. Now, I do have a video that really talks about the debt payoff strategies that you can use, and it goes into more detail in terms of the debt snowball method, which is used here. So if you haven't watched that, of course I will put that up here for you guys and in the description below. So in this scenario, in terms of sinking funds, she's busy trying to pay off her debt, so she's not got time to be going on holidays and all of that jazz. Okay, her main focus is going to be paying off her debt. But what she has realized is that she might need clothes during this year, so she has had to put a sinking fund for that. She's put in, let's say, £100, and she's going to be saving that throughout the whole year. So that means she just needs to be putting away about £8.33 per month into her sinking funds for clothes, for example. Again, she's in high interest debt, so at the moment things like holidays, Christmas presents, birthday presents, they're not really a priority right now. Okay, she's really going to be focusing on attacking that debt. So people who want Christmas presents, they're just going to have to wait till next year, unfortunately. But she can always give something that's free, which is her time. Just saying. So once Ronnie has figured out her sinking funds and her debt overpayments, she can now start doing her budget. So if we move over to January, what she has done is she has first put in her salary for the month. So I basically used an income tax calculator. So this is the income she is likely to have after tax. And also she might be paying her student loan. So I've included that within this figure as well. So if she's earning £38,000, this is ideally roughly how much she would get per month. So at the moment, Ronnie isn't actually putting any money into her savings or investments. She's really focusing on trying to pay off her debt. So we will move on to any essential bills or debt repayments. Now, when I say debt repayments, what I'm just talking about are any minimum payments that you might be making. So for example, in her case, she's making minimum payments on her store card, her credit card, and also her car finance as well. Now, personally, I like to put my charity and tithes in my essential bills category, because for me it is quite essential. But again, that's just me. So I haven't actually included anything for giving in this particular budget, but I do think it's really important. So I would definitely consider that when you are doing your own budget. So let's first go through Ronnie's essential bills and any debt repayments, because she lives in London, so she's got quite a lot of expenses at the moment. Now, how I've basically figured this out is I have just basically done research, and I've basically tried to look at the average figure for each category. So please don't shoot me, this isn't going to be 100% accurate, but this is just based on my research. It might be more, it might be less, I don't know. So let's look at her expenses. So she's currently paying rent, so she doesn't own a house, and she's currently paying about £1,300 per month. And she's not living so close to the city, she's just living just outside London. So she's paying about £1,300. And then she's also got utility bills with that as well. So she's paying about £35 a month for her water bill, £55 for her electricity, and about £45 for her gas. And then she's also paying for internet as well, so she's paying about £30 there. She has also got a phone contract, so she doesn't have a SIM only contract, she's paying for a phone contract, so she got an iPhone, and she's paying about £37 a month for her phone. She's also paying for TV license as well. Yes, I have tried to include everything. So she's paying about £12 for her TV license. She's also got council tax as well, so she's paying about £130 for her council tax. And then she's got some debt repayments there as well. So currently she's paying about £15 towards her credit card. Then she's also paying about £5 towards her store card, which is what I mentioned before. And then she's also paying about £186 towards her car loan. Then in terms of travel, so even though she has a car, she actually takes the train to work. So she has to pay about £150 for the month. But then she's also got her gym membership as well. So she has a direct debit for that. And she currently pays about £20 a month for that. And then also she's got life insurance, which is a good thing. So she's currently paying about £10 a month for that. So in total, she's paying over £2,000 just for essential bills. And this is exactly how I would do my budget. So I would list down every single thing that is going to be an essential bill for me. So these are things that I actually have to pay for. Now, you might decide actually whether you need to pay for gym membership, for example. So you might decide to put that in another category, but that's just where I've put it. But as an example, you will see in her spending category, she's got Netflix. I've put that into spending because she can easily just cancel that subscription, to be honest. I don't really see it as an essential bill. Whereas with the gym, you could potentially argue it just because you want to still be healthy whilst you are building wealth at the same time. So once she's put all of her debt repayments and we know that she's not currently going to be saving any money, what we're now going to do is we're going to add in her sinking funds. So we're going to go back to the sinking funds tab. I'm just going to add in what she's going to be saving from this month. So currently she's going to be saving £125 for her store card, so I will add that here. Plus she's also going to be putting money towards her clothes as well, so that was £8.33, I believe. So in total, that does mean that she will be putting about £133.33 a month this month towards her sinking funds and her debt overpayments. And you can currently see in total, she's spending about £2,163.46. So in terms of her salary, she has about £207.54 left to budget, which basically means when it comes to her spending, she's gonna have to try and cut costs. Again, the reason why she's trying to do that is because she's trying to overpay on her debt. If she didn't need to overpay on her debt, then of course she'd have much more to spend. But this is one of her key goals that she did set at the beginning of the year. Again, if you haven't set your January 2021 goals, I do have a video on that. So I will also put that in the description below. So let's now move over to spending. So in terms of spending, what I will try and do now is I will actually list my spending by priority. So for example, in this case, her groceries are going to be a priority. Now again, you could potentially put that in essential bills rather than your spending, but I'd like to just put it in my spending because when it comes to groceries, there are certain things that I probably might not buy if I don't have that much money. So yep, so we're gonna put groceries. And then let's say she spends about £80 a month because it's just her on groceries. Then next we're gonna look at her petrol because obviously she does have a car. Now she does use the train to work Monday to Friday, so really her car is gonna be used for the weekends. So she's not gonna need that much petrol for the weekend. So we're gonna say, let's say £40 a month. And then for toiletries, she also buys toiletries each month. So we are going to say £20. And so those are kind of her three top priorities. So the rest in terms of what she wants to spend on, she's just gonna have to make some sacrifices, to be honest. So in this case, she has decided that she does want to keep her Netflix subscription. So again, I've put that in terms of spending because personally, I don't think you absolutely need it. So I don't think it is essential, but she really wants to have her Netflix first. So she's going to be spending, is it £5.99 a month? You can pay, I think it's £5.99. That's a guess, don't quote me on that. And then it means that she only has money left over for basically either eating out or entertainment, or she can split them by both. So let's say she decides, okay, she's gonna go out maybe once in the month and spend £30 on eating out. And then she's also going to go out another time in the month and let's say spend £30 on entertainment. Now, in terms of what she has left to budget, it's about £1.55. So she's decided she's just gonna have that as a pennies jar. So anytime that she has loose change, she will just put that into a pot basically and let it grow. So she's just gonna put the rest of that money into there. So once Ronnie has done her monthly budget, obviously she can see that she's got a lot of expenses. So really I'll be trying to look at ways if I can decrease my expenses somehow, but then also at the same time, is there a possibility that I can actually increase my income? So for example, could she try and find a cheaper place to live? When it comes to things like utilities, is she using comparison sites to make sure she gets the best deal? Once her phone contract ends, could she think about maybe just getting a SIM only contract and just keeping the phone that she has. And then maybe with gym membership, she might decide to find somewhere cheaper, or she might even decide to start doing home workouts instead. Again, while she's doing that, she might also be trying to increase her income. So she may be trying to ask for a raise at work. She may be working overtime. She may even try to start a side hustle as well, so that if she does increase her income, but she's also decreased her expenses, that money can then be put towards her debt overpayment. So hopefully she can try and pay off her debt a bit faster. Now, the zero-based budget system might not be for everyone. So I do have a video talking through the other strategies that you can use to actually budget your money. So of course I will link that up here for you and in the description below. So then this is just what she will be doing, maybe even at the end of the month or at the beginning of the month. She will then just be updating each month, updating her budget, updating her net worth as well. So hopefully while she's doing that, she will start to see her liabilities slowly start to decrease. Now, someone had previously asked me whether I would do a budgeting video on someone that's maybe on Universal Credit, but I know with Universal Credit, it really depends on your circumstances. So what I've been thinking is showing you how I would budget maybe if I was on minimum wage, for example, and really showing you guys what exactly I would prioritize. So hopefully I'll be sharing that video with you guys quite soon. But if you did like this video, then please do give me a thumbs up, as it really does help to support the channel. And let me know in the comments, are you planning to budget this year? I do post every Tuesday and Friday, so if you would like to know more, then of course you can subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys on Tuesday.